This time, I'm going to talk about Black-Karasinski model and its calibration in Python. First, let's check out what are short-read models. Short-read model specifies the behavior of short-term interest rate. Short-read model can be classified into equilibrium and no-arbitrage models. Equilibrium models are also referred to as endogenous term structure models because the term structure of the interest rates is output of rather than an input to these models. No-arbitrage models designed to exactly match the current term structure of interest rates are more popular. Two of the most important non-arbitrage short-read models are Hall-White model and Black-Karasinski model. Let's take a look at Hall-White model first. This is a formula for Hall-White model. RT is the short-term interest rate at time t. The d here means the derivative. And theta t is the mean reversion level of the interest rate at time t. And alpha t is the mean reversion speed parameter. And sigma t is the instantaneous volatility of the interest rate at time t. And Wt is the standard Brownian motion. You can see theta t, alpha t, and sigma t are deterministic functions of time t. The function theta t is chosen so that the model fits the initial term structure of interest rates. The other two time-varying parameters, alpha t and sigma t, enable the model to be fitted to the market derivative prices. Before year 2012, people believed the interest rate shouldn't be negative. So, a model that addresses the negative interest rate issue of the Hall-White model is the Black and Karasinski model. This is the formula for the Black and the Karasinski model. You can see this is very similar to the formula of the Hall-White model. If we go back, you can see Hall-White model's formulas like this, and Black-Karasinski model's formula is like this. And basically, we have a log here. And all those terms definition is similar, and R0 is a positive constant. And similarly, theta t, alpha t, and sigma t are deterministic functions of time. Because in Black-Karasinski model, the interest rate cannot be negative. Sometimes we will get rid of this log and use this enhanced Black and Karasinski model. The Black-Karasinski model is a one-factor short-read model, and there are some key features. First, it has a mean reversion, and the model assumes the volatility of short-term interest rate is a function of the level of the interest rate, and the model allows for different term structure of interest rates by using different initial parameters. And the model assumes that the short-term interest rate follows a Gaussian distribution. The model can be calibrated to fit observed market prices of interest rate derivatives. The model can be easily extended to include multiple factors or to incorporate stochastic volatility. You can see if we want to calculate the interest rate, we have to know theta and alpha and sigma. Now I'm going to show you if we provide some value for theta t, alpha t, and sigma t, how can we calculate this interest rate with Black-Karasinski model. And also, I'll show you how to calibrate Black-Karasinski model. Now, let's go to Python. I implemented the formula of the original Black-Karasinski model here. And for the theta, I provide from 0.05 to 0.06. For sigma, I provided from 0.03 to 0.06. And for alpha, I put a constant at 0.1. You can see here, we have a random normal distributed number stand for this Brownian motion. And if we run this program, you can see the interest rate started from 0.05, and because theta is increasing, and so the curve will look like this. Of course, because we have this Brownian motion, if you run it again, it will show you a little bit different curve. And like I mentioned before, because sometimes the interest rate might become negative, we can also remove this log from the formula in this Black-Karasinski model to implement that. And without this log, I have it implemented here with all other parameters same. If we run this program, you can see it shows us a quite volatile curve because now we don't have log in this Black-Karasinski model. If you run it again, it shows a little bit different curve. Okay, now how can we calibrate this Black-Karasinski model? When we calibrate this Black-Karasinski model, sometimes the interest rate might become negative. Therefore, I'm using the enhanced Black-Karasinski model formula, that is, the formula without log. First, I defined this Black-Karasinski model, and this function will provide us the interest rate calculated from the model. Then, I generated some dummy market interest rate with this function. And also I save them into a local file. I'm going to upload all those Python program to my GitHub. You can download it and try it. And if you don't want to save this generated market rate data, you can just delete this piece of code. And for the initial guess for parameters, for theta, I use 0.05. For alpha, I use 0.3. And for sigma, I use 0.1. For the calibration, we use this function, calibration underscore obj. This will calculate the difference between the interest rate calculated by the model and the interest rate provided from the market. And we will try to minimize the difference between two interest rates. And here, I'm going to pass all those parameters to calibrate. After the calibration, I can get all the calibrated parameters. Because all those theta, alpha, and sigma are dependent on time t. So we will have so many calibrated parameters. And then I'm going to plot the market interest rate and the model interest rate and see the difference. And let's run the program. This is market rate I generated. You can see the blue line is the market rate and the orange line is the model rate. You can see this model rate goes up and comes down and goes up again. It's trying to match this market rates. And of course, because we have this Brownian motion in the model and also this market rate was generated with some dummy number. If we run it again, you can see you will have a different result. And because with this kind of calibration, there are so many parameters to be calibrated. There are other models. They are trying to fix this alpha as a constant. And sometimes they even fix this sigma as a constant. So they are not dependent to the time t. Maybe in the future, I will try to write some program to calibrate this Black-Karasinski model with constant alpha and constant sigma. This is my introduction about Black-Karasinski model and its calibration in Python. Please provide your comments and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.